Hello students, last time we have done lesson number 7, that is population. Let us revise what you have done. We discussed what is population, we seen what is population growth, we seen what is birth rate, death rate, life expectancy, migration of people, then distribution of population, and last we seen factors affecting population distribution. Now students, come to page number 44 in your textbook. We'll come to density of population. Now what you mean by density of population? It means is the number of people per unit of a area. Now density of population, the ratio of the population of a country to its area, its population density. While discussing population distribution, density of population is also considered. So we take the number of people per unit. It is also important while calculating the density of population. The density is calculated as per the formula given below. Now what is the formula? The formula is density of population equals to population of a region upon area of a region. Then next we have got complete the table that we will do in the class when our school will reopen. Now come to your right hand side, that is your structure of population. Now come to your right hand side, we have got something called structure of population. Now what structure of population means? It means that composition of a population shows how the population is divided between males and females of different age group. That is called your structure of population. Population can be subdivided into various categories by studying the correlation between the subdivisions and understanding of the structure and quality of the population is possible. We come to know by studying the structure of population or by subdividing the population. Now see here we have got groups like male, adolescent, illiterate. Illiterate means those are not able to read or write. Illiterate, children, unemployment, people who are not working, jobless, they are called unemployed. Infants, small children, infants, literate, who are educated, rural, working population, urban, female, old, young, dependent population. Dependent population means what? Old people are dependent upon others. And adult. Adult means grown up. Classify the above groups into the categories below, like sex, age, rural, urban, literacy, productive population. Productive population means working population, those who are working. Population can be subdivided as per the group given above. These subgroups and their relationship with one another is studied in the structure of the population. So all these factors we study in the structure of population. Now on the next page we have got something called sex ratio. Now what you mean by sex ratio? As per the gender, gender means what? Male and female. Population can be divided into males and females. Okay, so we can divide how many males are there in your family, how many females are there in your family. That is called your gender distribution. This is a natural division which can be easily understood. In a population with both the genders are around the same number, it indicates a balanced population. Now what is balanced population? When we have got both the genders, that is male and female, are same in number, it is called your balanced population. In population studies, the ratio of men and women is considered important. The ratio is calculated. Now how the ratio is calculated? It is calculated total number of females upon total number of males multiply 1000. When for every 1000 males the number of female is less, the sex ratio is said to be low. Remember now, when for every 1000 males the number of female is less, the sex ratio is said to be low. And when for every 1000 males the number of female is more, the sex ratio is said to be high. This is the way how we try to come to how sex ratio is been calculated. Now this graph we'll study in the class. Okay, come to your right hand side, you have got something called age structure. Now how we are going to study the age structure? See, on top of that something is given to you. How many people in your house are studying? What is their age? In your family, how many people are studying and what is their age? How many people in your house are working for a living? How old are they? How many people are working in your family? How they are supporting your family? That is called how many people in your house are working for a living? How old are they? Do your grandparents still work? What is your age? Whether your grandparents are working or not working, and what is their age? Now let's see. In a region, when the population is subdivided as per the age group, this is called age structure of the population. According to age, when population is subdivided, it is called age structure. Age structure is useful for the projection of population and for understanding the dynamics, understanding the changes in your family, in your understanding the dynamics of the age structure arrangement. Similarly, it also helps in understanding the proportion of active and dependent population. Active means what? How many members in your family are working? Dependent means what? How many family members are dependent upon the earning members in the family? In India, the productive population is the population between the ages 15 and 59. This group of people is active in services and business. At this age, people are working from 15 to 59. They directly participate in the economic activities of a region. Economic activities means they are going out, they are working something, or they have got some business, they are working member in the family. In regions where the proportion of this population is more, especially youth, development is rapid. If there are more youth, then the development takes place very fast. The dependent population fall into two subgroups. The people below 15 years of age are totally dependent on the productive population. People above 60 years also fall in dependent category, but their knowledge and experience make them a valuable asset to the whole society. Means what? After the age of 60, people don't work, they are dependent upon others, but what knowledge they have got, their knowledge is very important. Then we have got something called occupational structure of population. Occupation means what work they are doing. The population of a region can be classified into working and non-working groups. Those are working, they are called as working. Those are not working, they are called as non-working groups. These people who are not in jobs or profession, despite being in the productive age group, come under non-working group. Although they have got the age, but they are not working. That is called the non-working group. This non-working group is dependent on the working group. If the proportion of the working population is higher in region, then the population is termed as an industrious. Such a region has rapid development. Okay, students, in the next lecture we will continue with the same topic on population. So far I hope so you have understood. I will give a worksheet based on this topic, try to find the answers. If you are not able to find the answers, we will discuss in the next class. Thank you, students.